Dear students, welcome to the student competition for the best proposal to protect the coral reefs of Sint Maarten. My name is Erik de Ruiter van Stevenink and I'm a lecturer at IHC Delft Institute for Water Education in the Netherlands. And I will very briefly introduce you to some aspects of coral reefs. Here you see some pictures of a Caribbean coral reef and some of its inhabitants. But what now makes it a coral reef? Corals and other living organisms excrete limestone, and together they build a bank-like structure. And this structure, in turn, provides space and food for all kinds of other organisms. This then leads to a very high biodiversity, which is so characteristic for most coral reefs. So the main organisms in these reefs are the so-called stony corals. Stony corals are animals, but what makes them so special is the fact that they also contain algal cells, as shown here in the picture. And thus, just like normal animals, they eat organic matter. But because the algae are plants, they also need light. Because the stony corals that contain these algal cells need light, they can only build coral reefs in clear waters. And as they cannot survive low water temperatures, coral reefs are only found in the tropics, like in Sint Maarten. What makes coral reefs important? Coral reefs provide, and often they do that together with mangroves and seagrasses, many so-called ecosystem services that are beneficial for humans. Some examples: food. Could be fish, crabs, lobsters. Compounds that can be used to produce medicines. They protect the coastline against waves. Because the limestone skeletons of corals get also degraded, coral reefs produce the sand that makes up your white sandy beaches. And last, but certainly not least, the coral reefs and the beaches attract many tourists and thus provide an income for many people working in the tourist sector. Unfortunately, coral reefs are also very sensitive. They are sensitive to turbid waters and sedimentation, because, as you now know, they depend on light. They are sensitive to nutrients from wastewater and fertilizers from agriculture, because that stimulates the growth of benthic algae that can overgrow the corals and prevent recruitment of new corals. Fish and sea urchins normally keep the cover and the density of benthic algae low, and thus help corals to survive. Overfishing will lead to a decrease in these grazers, and this can result in algae overgrowing the corals. And they also don't like other forms of pollution. You can think of plastics, or sunscreen, oil, etc. They are sensitive to increased water temperatures, for example, because of global warming. Only a small increase in temperature can stimulate corals to expel their algal cells. Thus, their tissue becomes transparent, and what you then see is their white limestone skeleton. And that's why this is called coral bleaching. Sometimes bleached corals survive, but often they become more sensitive to other disturbances and they might die. They are also sensitive to direct physical contact. Their tissues can die if you just touch them, let alone if you stand on them. And strong waves and storms can also break corals. So what about the relation between tourists, very important for Sint Maarten, and coral reefs, also very important? Tourists will create jobs, and which results in income for the population. This, of course, is very positive. However, as these tourists need food, they can contribute to overfishing. And as they visit the toilet, they increase the amount of wastewater, which leads to more nutrients in the water. And thus, high numbers of tourists can stimulate the overgrowth of corals by algae. If these tourists dive and throw out anchors, corals might break. Construction activities, for example, to build hotels and yacht harbors, will increase sedimentation. Solid waste, including plastics, often end up in the coastal waters. And swimmers can release toxic sunscreens into the water. This is, as we have seen, all very unhealthy for coral reefs. And as a result, coral reefs die. Therefore, it's so important to balance tourism with the protection of the natural environment, coral reefs in particular. This last slide might give you some ideas how you yourself can help saving coral reefs, and maybe some inspiration for developing a project to protect the coral reefs of St. Maarten. It also includes a link to a website that provides lots of information about coral reefs and that might be helpful for developing some ideas. If you have further questions, you can always contact me by email. My address is on the first slide. Thank you for your attention and good luck with the coral competition.